Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Fresh Baked and Stuff here at Walt Disney World. I am your host, Laramie Williams. And check this out, you guys. I, courtesy of some friends of mine, get to enjoy a fantastic lunch here at the Crystal Palace, which I've never been to before. So it is a it's a character dining experience with Winnie the Pooh and friends. We were going to do breakfast, but we missed breakfast, so they bumped us. They still let us keep our reservation, which is awesome of Disney here. And look at this. Carved meats, vegetable creations, seasonal fish, soup, pastas, peel and eat shrimp, chicken, and to top it all off, soft serve ice cream. I'm very excited because we also get to meet Winnie the Pooh and friends. So super excited, you guys. We're waiting right now to go in, but I think the plan for today, I'm gonna go inside the Crystal Palace, which is right here at Magic Kingdom, by the way, right off of Main Street. That's Casey's Corner right back there. And then after I film lunch here, I think that's probably gonna do it for me today, because guess what, you guys? Mr. David Reynolds himself comes in tomorrow. I'm very excited, so I'm gonna do the rest of the trip report with David, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna be back here at Magic Kingdom, but I'm still gonna be wandering around on Periscope and whatnot. So we'll see where the Disney winds guide me today. I might, if I find something worth filming, I'll definitely show you guys. Otherwise, I wanna, you know, film as much as possible with David, because I love that little man. You know what, guys? So I thought of something while I'm waiting here. I just gotta say, you know, thank you guys so much from the bottom of my heart for your patience, because I haven't been filming as often as I would like to, mainly because of work. If you notice in last week's trip report, you'll see right after I rode Tower of Terror, I was like, yeah, I'm gonna be back tomorrow and show you guys all the great stuff. And then there was no more footage. So what happened is on my day off, I got called into work because we were just crazy slammed. We are in the peak season at work, so it is just very, very busy. And it's been so busy, all these mandatory overtime hours were supposed to stop in March. However, now they've been extended through May. Yay! So exciting. So anyway, you guys, exciting at all. Thank you so much for your patience. I know you guys have been super supportive. I read every single one of the comments on YouTube when the videos are posted. So thank you very much for your support. It means a lot to me. Life does indeed happen. But I'm trying, you guys, as often as I can to get here and film and bring you guys the best that Disney World has. Baked fresh daily. So thank you guys again so much. But yeah, we still waiting for breakfast here at the Crystal Palace. Oh my gosh, Fresh Baked. This place is adorable. So this reminds me very much of the Plaza Inn at Disneyland, honestly. On the inside, the decorum here looks just like that. Look at this banner right here. Welcome to our Friendship Day celebration. Because Winnie and Winnie the Pooh and friends wrote that. And I'm actually super excited myself, you guys. I, believe it or not, have never done a character dining experience in my life. So I'm like super excited. I see Piglet back there. Oh, you guys, so happy. Look at this, Tigger, Piglet. Eeyore was here earlier. So I'm super happy, you guys. But it is a buffet, it's all you can eat. And I'm going to do just that. But they've got everything, you guys, from salmon to what's over here. Ooh, so we got chicken and mac and cheese, chicken tenders, rolls and salad, and looks like different kinds of pasta, peel and eat shrimp down there. All sorts of stuff, you guys. Mashed potatoes, broccoli, corned beef and cabbage, honey glazed, salmon, honey soy glazed salmon, interesting. Herb-crusted tilapia. So there's a lot of choices. Pretty much whatever you eat, you're gonna be able to find something here at the Crystal Palace. So when I'm gonna grab some food, and when Winnie the Pooh and Tigger 2 and everyone else comes to the table, I'll go ahead and film that. Check this out, Fresh Baked. It's a special Pooh celebration. They're marching around the room with all their friends. I don't see where Tigger and Eeyore and everyone is, but it's so fun.
don't know if you guys can hear the music playing, but
I bet they're doing it on the other side. This is so fun, you guys. So far, the food is really, really good. I've only barely started on a Caesar salad, some peel and eat shrimp, all you can drink chocolate milk. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me, Fresh Baked? All you can drink chocolate milk. I know, I'm five, but it's amazing. How can you not be? Have chocolate milk when you're dining with Winnie the Pooh. All right, Fresh Baked, and now for the main course. I've got some honey glazed salmon, some jambalaya, green beans, cheese pierogi, flank steak, I think, turkey, ham, or a smoked ham, and cheddar soup, chocolate milk still. It's amazing. Still no characters. They're making their way, guys, right there. There's Pooh Bear, Piglet, Eeyore's over here on the left, so they're slowly coming around. I'm excited. Can you tell? I'm very excited. Hi, Pooh Bear! Yay! Oh my gosh, it's Winnie the Pooh! He's coming to see us! And Piglet at the same time! Oh, Piglet's almost here.
Everybody smile!
Oh, DJ, you might want to put a hat on.
This is the family I'm with today, okay. Fresh Baked. The Cowie family, they're amazing.
I think Pooh blinked, I'm sorry.
Let me... They're visiting us from Texas.
Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay.
All right, you guys. I gotta go give this silly old bear a hug.
You want to
hug cam, Pooh Bear. Hi, Pooh Bear. Yay!
Piglet, don't leave. I need a hug, Piglet.
Piglet, hug cam. Uh-oh. Whoa, it's Piglet in 3D. Thanks, Piglet. All right, I've done a Pooh cam and a Piglet cam. Now I gotta do an Eeyore hug cam. Thanks, Eeyore. Woo-hoo! Bye. Oh my gosh, Fresh Baked. I have been hugged by everyone except that guy, and he's coming. He's coming, you guys. I'm very excited. Tigger! I gotta get a hug. I gotta get a hug. Hug him. Hi, Tigger. Bye. Fresh Baked. She didn't say no recording.
You're in for a real treat.
They might have changed the rules.
Carousel of Progress was Walt's own idea from beginning to end. He loved it. He introduced the show at the World's Fair in New York City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. Millions of people came to see it. And since then, the Carousel of Progress has had more performances than any other stage show in the history of American theater. You know, Walt loved the idea of progress, and he loved the American family. And he himself was probably as American as anyone could possibly be.
That's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow shining at the end of every day. Beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Ah, it looks like the Robins are getting ready to celebrate Valentine's Day today. What year is it? Oh, right around the turn of the century. And believe me, things couldn't be any better than they are today. Yes, sir, buildings are towering now as high as 20 stories. And moving pictures flicker up on a big screen. We have almost 8,000 automobiles in this country, and we can travel by train from New York to California in less than 7 days. And I even hear tell about two brothers in North Carolina who are working on some kind of flying contraption. It'll never work. Closer to home, we've now got gas lamps, a telephone, and the latest design in cast iron stoves. And that reservoir keeps 5 gallons of water hot in just 3 buckets of coal. Oh boy, it sure beats chopping wood. And isn't our new ice box a beauty? Look at that, holds 50 pounds of ice. Milk doesn't sour as quick as it used to. And our dog Rover here keeps the water in the drip pan from overflowing. It wasn't too long ago we had to carry water from a well. And thanks to progress, we've got a pump right here in the kitchen. Of course, we keep a bucket of water handy to prime it with. Yes, sir. We've got everything we need to make life easier. Say, Mother, I was reading about a fellow named Tom Edison who's working on an idea for snap-on electric lights.
Electric lights? No more kerosene. No more gas.
Sarah sure gets to the core of the apple.
But we do have this new wash day marvel. Now it takes me only 5 hours to do the wash. Imagine, it used to take 2 days.
Well, that's right, folks. Now Sarah has time for other things
like canning and cleaning the oven.
Yes, dear.
Well, ovens don't just clean themselves, you know.
I know, dear. And they probably never will.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got to get the laundry on the line before it starts raining cats and dogs.
Oh, don't worry, Rover. She didn't mean real dogs. Besides, it's not going to rain today. My lumbago isn't acting up. Boy, look at it come down. All you have to do is put your wash on the line, right? Oh, well, the cistern was low anyway.
Wow, wait, look at that.
Now, James, I thought I told you to ask my permission before using my new stereoscope. That's not a toy, you know.
Ooh la la, so that's little Egypt doing the hoochie-coochie, eh, Dad?
Isn't she a knockout? She's the star of the New World's Fair in St. Louis, and... Now, you put that away before your mother finds it.
Aw, Dad.
You heard me. Well, we have one of those new talking machines. Now, that is something. It plays music right here in our home.
Oh, Papa.
Yes, Patricia?
Papa, all these people. I'm indecent.
Don't worry, Patricia. They're friends. That's our teenage daughter. She's getting ready to go to a Valentine's dance across town on one of those new horseless trolleys.
I think it's very romantic you're taking Mother out for Valentine's dinner this evening.
Well, you know what kind of sport I am.
I only hope I have an evening as romantic as yours and Mother's.
Now, you be home by 9 o'clock, daughter. You hear me?
Yes.
Oh, well, with all this talking, I've worked up quite a thirst. I think I'll take one of those newfangled trolleys down to the drugstore soda fountain and meet the boys for a cold sarsaparilla. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot. We're drinking root beer now. Same kind of thing, different name. Well, that's progress for you. And speaking of progress...
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away.
For those of you wondering, Fresh Baked, the seats are moving, not the stage. It's pretty cool.
With mind and heart, and when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day.
Boy. Hottest 4th of July we've had in years. We've come a long way, though, since the turn of the century, over 20-some-odd years ago. You know that pilot fella, Charles Lindbergh? He's about to fly a single-wing airplane all the way across the Atlantic. He's never going to make it. And sports stadiums are springing up all over. And boy, nobody hits that old horse hide like that new fella, Babe Ruth. Jazz music is the cat's meow. And there's been ads in the paper for months for a movie starring Al Jolson. And he's going to talk and sing. Boy, I've got to see that. We've got a house full of new electrical servants. Mr. Edison sure added life to our home. Well, there, you blew a fuse. Crap, that's the third one this week. I buy fuses by the case. And I've blown the whole neighborhood again. You know, next year I'd like to go as Benedict Arnold.
Wait until you see what I've got planned for the fireworks show tonight.
Rover, don't interrupt while Sarah's interrupting.
And guess who volunteered to choose the music for the program?
I did, Pop. Listen to this.
Oh, that's a nice tune, Jimmy. You know, with our new Crosley radio set... Oh, coming, Martha, as I was saying, considering all the conveniences we now have, I'll say that we're really on Easy Street these days. It just can't get any better. Just goes to show that there's a great big beautiful tomorrow,
it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away. Well, it's another Halloween here in the fabulous 40s. Everything is better than ever now, and we've got some amazing new wonders around the house to prove it. For instance, our refrigerator holds more food and ice cubes. And thanks to our automatic dishwasher, oh, I don't have to dry the dishes anymore after supper. Gives Rover and me more time to enjoy our evening stroll together. Later, boy. Oh, and here's something else that's new. I just heard a new term today on the radio. Fella says, we've got something now called the rat race. Did you ever hear that one? It sure describes my life. I'm involved in something now called commuting. I drive into the city for work all day and then turn right around and drive all the way back. Well, we're caught up in the do-it-yourself craze these days. We're remodeling our basement in something called a rumpus room. And we're looking forward to a few rumpuses, I'll tell you, as long as they don't get out of hand.
John, this papering is getting out of hand. I could use a little help.
Now, Sarah, didn't I set up that clever automatic paint stirring machine for you?
Yes, John, you're a genius. Of course, this will ruin my food mixer. Not that you'd care.
Oh, good old Sarah. Always the last laugh. What happened, Sarah?
Oh, Progress. That paint mixer of yours just sloshed paint across my room.
Pleasant holiday. Now our turkey's in the oven. It's peaceful and quiet.
Yes! 300 points. My best score yet.
Well, it was peaceful until Santa brought that new virtual reality space pilot game.
Your turn, Grandma. Let's switch the image over to the TV so the resident flying ace can show you how it works. Now, it's a little tricky. Just use your game glove to fly behind the other guy and blast him with your laser blaster.
Laser blaster? Well, I'll give it a try.
Take a look around, Grandma. You're in the ship.
Feels like I'm really there.
Okay, get ready. You're about to blast off.
Here goes nothing. Whoa.
All right, here it comes. Oh, you missed him.
Hey, everybody. I'm done programming our new voice activation system.
Now all our household items will do anything we tell them.
Anything up next?
Who knows? We've got a whole new century waiting for us out there.
Yeah, and maybe sometime in the new century, your father will learn how to talk to our oven.
Well, maybe by then ovens will read our minds. But hey, as long as we're all here and happy and together for the holidays, who cares if I burned our Christmas turkey?
I do. I'm starving.
Don't worry, Dad. Someday, everything's going to be so automated, you won't ever have to cook another Christmas turkey again.
Was amazing. I am so glad I finally got to show you guys the Carousel of Progress. She didn't make the announcement beforehand saying no filming of any type. So I was like, sweet! And I pulled out the camera as soon as I could. I was really happy. So anyway, there you go. But I will see you guys tomorrow. I'm coming back with David Reynolds. He will be in town and the adventure will continue. Look, Fresh Baked, I'm back at Magic Kingdom. I told you I would be, and I found, you know what? I just have no words. Look what I found. I found a David Reynolds. So check it out, Fresh Baked. We got fast passes for Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. Very, very excited. Are you excited?
I'm very excited. It's a 110-minute wait, so I'm like super pumped that we got a little fast pass.
It's only 110. Last night, it was like two hours, David. So that's 120.
I'm not good at math.
That's
sorry.
Like 120 minutes. Nice. Oh, boy. All right. So anyway, we're going to do this, Fresh Baked. I'm pumped. I'm jazzed that you're here, David.
I'm super excited to be here. Super excited and excited to like be on property this time around.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Get a lot of extra perks with that, so I'm super excited.
And you're here for a week.
A whole
week. We get a week of David Reynolds, so
yes.
I'm excited. We're going to buzz in. We're going to do this live at Fresh Baked. That's called a happy dance. He's very... Hi! We were commenting on your happy dance.
Thanks.
Are you're happy for the ride in general, right?
Yes.
You know why?
Yes, I do.
Why?
I don't know what pun it's going to be, but it's going to be about happy.
I don't. Why would I tell a happy pun? No, this ride is so good because all the others dwarf in comparison.
Okay, all right.
I've probably used it. See, that's the problem with all the puns is I don't know which ones I've
you
used.
Have
what I've said and done on Periscope.
Somebody start keeping up with that.
Yeah, if only we had a pun counter. Oh, wait, that's right. We did. And then he got bored. Okay. Uh-oh. Magic band. Grab my magic band. It ripped off. thank you. Yay!
Woohoo! Woo!
Chugga 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 chugga. Oh, that's what's from Genie from the Aladdin show. That's what we did. We just got hug Jafar. He'd be like, chugga, chugga, chugga.
Oh, yeah, I've never seen that. It's gone.
Oh, bummer. It's an awesome show.
Woo!
Rocket! Rocket! Ah! Oh, this ride rocks! I'm serious, man. This is really a gem of a ride. This is nice.
Yeah, it's a nice view.
This is. Oh, here we go. All right.
Here we go.
I think the David and Laramie cam might be a little boring.
Is it?
I'm just. It's a little boring. What do you guys think?
I'm boring?
No, you're not boring. Oh, Snow White. Look,
she's way more.
She's way more interesting. Yay! She's dancing. In a little bit. Yeah, I don't know if you guys knew that, Fresh Baked. All those dwarves and the set pieces and everything inside there, that's all from the previous Snow White ride that they had. Even this ugly lady, look at her. Selling her apples. What a jerk. All right, Fresh Baked, I'm very excited. David doesn't know who he is because he doesn't watch one of the world's greatest TV shows, apparently.
I'm sorry.
But I just saw Glenn Howerton from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. So that was amazing. He was with a plaid in the Fast Pass line. So that was pretty cool. That was fun. I'll add that to my celebrity checklist at Disney World. Good Lord. Who is that? Weird Al, Nathan Fillion, Gina Davis.
I saw the girl from Stranger Things, Billy Bobby Brown.
Oh, yeah? Sure.
She's awesome. That show's awesome.
That's cool. All right, where are we headed? Hi. How about we go to Splash Mountain?
Okay.
I'm not gonna film Splash Mountain. I'm scared. Okay, so check this out, Fresh Baked. Last time, so when I did, who was I with? I was with Grace, and I was filming, whatchamacallit, the, Animal Kingdom, the splashy.
Oh,
Kali
River.
When I was filming Kali, the camera got nailed. And I mean, it just, a huge wave. You check it out if you guys haven't seen the trip report. But it was a big sploosh. And now I keep getting this error message that always pops up saying like, this camera does not take still pictures or something like that. Yeah. I'm like, oh great. So let's not get the camera wet anymore.
No big deal.
Is what I've learned from this experience. So I think we're just gonna go enjoy Splash Mountain. And then, you know what guys, we're gonna head over, we're gonna go check in at the resort. At the Art of Animation, and I'm going to show you guys the Art of Animation and the Lion King suite, because that'll be pretty sweet. Oh, she does not like that pup at all.
She thought it was as funny as I did.
David, you look a little, you're all wet.
I am a little wet.
I am too.
It was worth it though, it's fun.
It was worth it. It was very, very cold. It was fantastic. That Splash Mountain that you guys didn't get to see. But now we're gonna do something David Reynolds here has never done before. And we're gonna do the magic carpets of Aladdin. Where are you going? You're passing the fast pass. David, come back!
Yeah, let's get around the bacon.
Getting around. That is bacon. That's bacon.
I wonder if his name's Kevin.
Why Kevin? Kevin the bacon? What do you mean? I'm confused. You got nothing. Okay. Anyway, so moving on, we're going to ride the... Oh, Aladdin. Aladdin has an announcement. Aladdin doesn't care that I'm filming, David.
I'm filming.
I am filming. All right, so, yeah, we're going to ride this and hopefully get more wet. Because that camel right over there is probably going to spit right on us.
Is this one we're riding?
Yes.
I thought it was just like the one over there that
no,
went
right past. No, there's one that spits on us as we ride, which is amazing. Yeah. I mean, not we might not get it, though, so you never know. You never know. But we've never done it, so we're going to ride this, and it shall be fun, Fresh Baked. We're going to have fun.
Until your magic carpet comes to a complete stop, then walk to the nearest exit. Hope you're on a magical ride. See you soon!
All right, Fresh Baked. Look. The David Laramie cam is back. Oh, wow.
I'm on a carpet!
All right. I got the height. We're going up.
Okay.
Make us tilt.
I don't know what to do.
Tilt us forward.
How do I do that?
You push the thingy, my Bob.
I'm pushing the thingy, my Bob.
I'm going to lower us. Hopefully the camel spits on us. Oh, wow. We're bouncing.
No.
Okay, hold on. I got to turn this. Let's see. All right. Here comes the camel. So I gotta lower. No. What? There we go. There's a camel. I don't think he's working, Fresh Baked. All right. Going back up.
I don't know how to do this.
Keep switching it. Do the thing.
Push. Must go faster.
Get off the stick. Bloody move. Oh, hey, look at all the genies right there. That's cool.
I love that.
That's awesome. That's fun. We're going down. Slowly. There we go. Okay, I guess we're not. Oh, we're bouncing. We're bouncing, Fresh Baked. Dave, there, I think you're tilting it.
Really?
Yeah, you just made it go forward.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't do anything.
Sure. I don't know. Oh, great. David, the ride's over.
I tried.
Fresh Baked. He does not know how to ride this. But you know, in all fairness, he's never done it before. So that's okay. That's fine.
It's fine.
It's good. All right. So now we're done. That was good. This way. So I have a very, very excited person right here, Fresh Baked. Because we are going to Sunshine Tree Terrace. And we're going to stand in this ridiculously long line for what is probably the most delicious tasty treat here at Walt Disney World. Oh my gosh, this is, this is the longest I've ever seen this line.
It's okay. It's fine.
It is okay, because it's amazing and delicious. So, you guys, this is... I don't know that I've shown you guys this before. Think of, like, a Dole Whip, except instead of pineapple, it is... Well, you describe it, because it's your favorite thing ever.
It's like orange juice slush.
Yeah, well, it's like...
Look, the line's back there.
Oh, that's the line. Oh, we just cut in front of everyone. We're amazing.
They were, like...
There we go, and now they...
Standing on the wall, so I didn't know. It was unclear. It was unclear where the line was. Anyway, it's an orange juice slush, and then it's swirled with
vanilla
ice cream. Mm-hmm, thank you.
Mm-hmm. So instead of like a pineapple Dole Whip, it's an orange juice whip.
Yes.
Whip.
But not the.
It's an orange juice whip.
What's the Dole? What's the Dole Whip with the juice?
No, that is the Dole Whip float.
Float. So it's not a float. It's like just the Dole Whip.
Yeah.
They don't have orange juice
right
in there with it. It's real good.
Yes, it is. I'm excited. I'm always excited. I've been excited all weekend. Wait till you see this trip report, because I say I'm excited like all the time. Stop cheating. I'm not ready to film. Okay, go. He's very excited. Fresh baked. Look at this, you guys. So mine like melted and broke and fell over, so they put it in a big cup. But that's what it normally looks like. An orange juice. Like, oh, I'm like drooling, just excited. Yep, this is happening right now. I'm very excited. Hey, there we go, there it is. I said it again. I'm very excited. All right, so we're gonna slowly stroll out of Magic Kingdom here, Fresh Baked, and then, we're headed over to the Art of Animation, where we get to see the Lion King suite, and I'm gonna show you guys the whole resort, so this should be fun. And David, you know what?
What?
I'm really excited. Well, I made it, Fresh Baked. Check this out. I am impressed. I haven't even been here. This is super cool. Look at this. So this is the Art of Animation Resort, and I'm already struck at how just like Disney-fied it is. and it's enormous. It goes like way down there, but I keep saying how I'm really excited, but I am really excited to check out this resort and film this one for you, because I get to actually stay here with David for a couple nights. So pretty excited for that. So I'll get to show you guys the inside of a room here in a minute as soon as I check them in. But wow, these are huge. That's a lot of aerial. And you can definitely find Nemo when he's that big. That's all I'm saying. anyway, this is pretty cool. Let's go on in. Oh, here we are. Oh my gosh. Wow, this is awesome. Okay, see, I really appreciate good art, because that is not something I can do. As you guys saw a few weeks ago when I was doing when I was drawing Goofy in the Animation Academy, that is, yeah. Drawing and this guy, not something that goes well together. So I definitely appreciate all the art that goes behind everything from animation like this to different comic books, you know, graphic novels, all that good stuff. Like it's just amazing. I've never understood how to do it. Wow. God, you guys, look at this. This wall alone is just incredible. And then look at this. We got the lobby here, which is really cool. You got all the different colors. But, oh, nice. Look at Crush. He's like, dude. Ariel, Lightning McQueen. Oh, so as we move along, it's so they turn from the black and white sketches down at the end to adding some different colors to really adding some color in and filling in the color. Oh my gosh, you guys. Wow, I'm blown away by this. This is really cool. Look at that lightning. I'm excited for Cars 3, by the way. Are you guys? It's gonna be a different film, I think, but I'm excited for it. Wow, they got bathrooms. Okay, and then... Wow, look at these. They're like, They're like blown up cells, but they're different because they're more sketches than the actual finished product of the cell, which is really cool. Oh, that's awesome, you guys. All Little Mermaid cars up at the top. This is sick. So I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna go ahead and check in Fresh Baked, and then I'm gonna go inside this ink and paint shop. I'm gonna wait for some of this other stuff here until David gets here, because I just got here from the park and he's still, he was parked in Heroes, I was parked in Villains, so let's be real. Villains were a little quicker. They get the job done faster, so I got here before he did, but he's on his way, guys. So yeah, I'm gonna wait for him. We're gonna check in, and then we're gonna check out the rest of the resort. Oh wow, hey, look at this. Oh, that is the coolest chandelier ever. Hold on, let me push in. Oh, there's no way. Shenzi and Ed and, oh, Banzai. That is so cool. Ursula and Trident. Oh my gosh, are these actually hand-drawn cells by the original animators? That would be something worth checking out. I'm going to find out. All right, Fresh Baked. So David just got here. He's checking into the room. I already checked him in, but he's loading all his bags and stuff. So I figured we'd come in here and check out the ink and paint shop, which looks like... So it looks like just your typical resort shop with different things, you know, doodads and trinkets that you would find. You know, we of course got our shirts and mugs and all that fun stuff. You know, Advil and bread and snacks and all those good old doodads. Oh, that's cool. Ooh, what is this? A genie. I'm not sure what this is. Brito. Pop artist Romeo Brito uses vibrant colors, bold patterns as a visual language of hope and happiness. He has been credited with the largest public art installation in Hyde Park history. And exhibited at the Carousel de Louvre Museum. I'm sure I pronounced that wrong. Brito.com. Nice. Wow, these are really cool. Different takes on not a toy for decorative use only. Well, duh. I don't see how much it is. Let's see if it's in the box. I don't see a price, Fresh Baked.
Okay, thank you.
Huh. I'm not... Yeah, none of these have prices. Okay. I'm sure they're not inexpensive, because these are definitely pretty cool. Donald and Pluto. Oh wow, look at the Stitch one. That's fun. That's nice, different take on things. Everything else, yeah, it's looking like everything else. I mean, from plushies to, ooh, Duffy. Oh no way, a Duffy costume, that's cool. Little outfit. Oh, it's a Buzz Lightyear outfit for your Duffy bear. Oh, that's cool. All right, Yoda hats. Yeah, everything else looks like normal fare here that you would find at any Disney gift shop. So, but it is, of course, matching the theming of the Art of Animation, which is really cool. That's why you got all the ink and paint canisters up at the top. And then in here, so we got a Landscape of Flavors, which I think is just a quick service location. Yeah, it is. Quick service meals, breakfast, lunch, dinner. There you go. For guests on the dining plan. Okay. So yeah, so it is just quick service. Oh, here, let's go take a look. Let's see what kind of food they're serving here. So salads, turkey sandwiches, caprese sandwich, barbecue pork sandwich, Mongolian grilled fish. Ooh, Mongolian... Mongolian? Oh my gosh, that wasn't just me, right? That didn't say Mongolian, it said Mongolian. Was that a typo? Chicken burger? I want to see this refresh. Yeah, look, Mongolian grilled fish here, but Mongolian grilled beef stir fry. That's funny. I wonder if that's done on purpose or not. Anyway. Well, yeah, so that's cool. So just quick service, breakfasts, cereals, all sorts of good stuff. But what I want to do, Fresh Baked, I want to go outside. Let's take a look at the pool. I kind of feel bad. I don't want to see too much without David here, because he is here. But, yeah, I'm gonna go outside to the pool here. Let's check that out. All right, you guys. Oh, my gosh. the big blue pool. You guys, look at this. Wow, that's huge. Look at Crushman over there. Are you serious? It looks like he's a painting on film here, but he's not. He might anyway. Okay, no, there he is. He's popping out a little bit. Wow, you guys, this is crazy. Super cool. Look at this. Look. It's Nemo and Marlin both in the the sea plant. Looks like French fries. We'll just call it sea French fries. No, they're in the sea anemone. That is so cool. Wow, the building is awesome. And then, so that building's called the Drop Off. Oh, so that's a bar. Oh, nice. I might be hitting that up later for sure. But now I wanna walk over here. I wanna go, definitely wanna go check in. And that way is the Lion King suite. So I'm gonna go check it out. Now, if I'm not mistaken, Fresh Baked, with that Finding Nemo pool, oh my gosh, I see a cool reflect. Wow. Look at this. That's awesome, you guys. Wow. Can you imagine if those were real? Do you have any idea how much poop there'd be? Wow, it's huge. That is awesome. So that's the same pool. But so with the Finding Nemo pool, according to Mr. David Reynolds, he says that when you dunk your head underwater, you can actually hear music from Finding Nemo, which is super cool. A theory that I definitely plan on checking out. But this, wow, look at this. Okay, so this is the Lion King side of things, because there's three or four sides, I think, to the Art of Animation. You've got the Lion King, which we're staying in. Oh, with Rafiki. I said that weird. Rafiki. There we go. Look at this, you guys. I'm like ADD all over the place. This is awesome. Look at this. No stinking way. La santé sans the squash banana. Oui, nougou, mimi, empana. So, what was I saying? Oh yeah, so a few different sides. So the Lion King, the Finding Nemo side, I think there's a Little Mermaid side, and Little Mermaid and Cars. But we, David opted to stay in the Lion King side. Oh my gosh, this is super cool. Look at this, you guys. There is a log with Pumbaa, Timon, and Simba crossing. Wow. Okay, I gotta get closer to this. This is super cool. Look at this. How sick is this? Wow, you guys. Okay, see, this right here, all this business, this is why Disney does resorts way better than anyone else in the world. Are you serious right now? The big fallen over tree, and then the animation shot. Oh my gosh. That is just sick, you guys. All right, I'm impressed. I thought this resort would be nothing too fancy, nothing too cool, but, oh no way, Scar's over there. Oh, in the elephant graveyard. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm gonna go grab David. He's in the room, and we're gonna take a look at the room first here in at the Lion King suite. It's actually a family suite. Hi guys. The family suite. Oh, okay. So, hallways. Looks pretty typical. I guess we're on the fourth floor. I'm gonna go on up to the room and meet David. Look at this, you guys. I just came out of the elevator here on the fourth floor, was greeted by Zazu. And then check this out. Rafiki up there in the trees. It's just different animation. This is sick. Okay, so apparently our room is somewhere over here, so I'm gonna find it. Okay, so I found the room, and for those of you that don't know, the magic band acts as a room key as well. And I thought David was here. I guess he's not. he's downstairs. He's probably gonna come in like any second while we're filming here. But check this out, you guys. Wow, look at this. So this is just regular table here. Plastic chairs, so you can sit down. So this is the Lion King family suite, is what this is. I'll just try and pan slowly. So there's a master bedroom there, which is going to be David's. I get the pull-out couch, because that is a bed. That's actually a queen-size bed that pulls out of there. And from what I hear, it's actually pretty darn comfortable. So I'm excited for that. And then we got one bathroom here. Hi, guys. Oh, nice. Sweet. Literally, sweet. And there's no little girls to scream at that pun. Oh, that is so cool. Timon and Pumbaa are taking a shower in the shower. Standard shower. Okay. Normal. Cool. No way. Okay. You guys, are you serious right now? That is so cool. Why does that make me so happy? Oh, yeah. Because it's awesome. Wow. Okay. Moving on. I won't sing anymore. I'm sorry. Okay, so we got a little kitchenette here. Microwave, sink, refrigerator, storage, giraffes. Wow. This is awesome. Okay. TV, shelf. So there's a storage bin down here. You know, how cool would this be if there were like, this whole thing was loaded with like Disney DVDs. Yeah, we're not that cool. So it's just empty drawers. Okay. But I'm sure you can order them for a price. Chairs. And then our view is of the parking lot, which is beautiful. Said no one ever. Okay, well that's could be worse. It's not bad. But look at the side of the buildings there. Simba. Oh, so he's animated. Okay, so he's running and bounding and jumping and oh, that's cool. Okay. So, now let's go check out David's bedroom. Oh, nice. You got Zazu. Looks like he's got a queen bed. Is that a queen bed? Oh, I'm zoomed in. Sorry. Queen or king bed? I don't know. Probably a king. But he's got a TV as well with lights. He's got his window, same view. And then his master bathroom. Wow. This is just... I don't know. I think this is cool. And he's got the same stinking African sun. That is so cool. With a glass shower. Okay. Ooh, that slammed. Alright, this is cool. Well, I guess that's it, Fresh Bake. This is the Lion King family suite here in the Art of Animation with some weird birds that are probably from The Lion King 2, which I haven't seen. Here he is! I couldn't delay for much longer. You're good? So I already gave them the full tour. Would you like the full tour?
Yes, show me.
Okay, here's the room. Here's your room.
Okay, perfect.
That's pretty cool. this is...
Did you show them this?
What?
We have to see this.
The table and chairs?
Yes, the table and chairs.
Yes, I showed them. Is there something special?
Yes, watch.
Oh, I did not know this. Have you stayed here before?
No. I just read this thing when I was up here a second ago. Hang on.
What are you reading?
Wait for it. Oh!
Directions. Oh, that's the bed. What? Where is Roger Rabbit in there? That's what I was expecting. I thought the couch was the pullout.
No. The Murphy bed.
Well, why are these cushions so... No, these look too big.
This is probably
See, out. That is a pull-out bed
yeah.
as I destroy the couch. Okay, so that's probably... That wow.
Yeah.
All right.
Awesome.
So that...
And okay, the refrigerator. We'll just,
there we go. Yeah,
I got the... I am really stoked about this. I'm gonna hit the grocery.
Just, is it loaded? Do we have...
No.
No mini bar? Okay, that's fine. But that... Dude.
Isn't that awesome? I did my research.
That's so cool.
Did you see the tile in the shower in here?
Yes.
Like from the beginning of the movie?
Yes. So yeah, it's also, it's in here too, yeah, in the tile here. But you got, in that bathroom, there's the curtain, but in this bathroom is the glass. So you got the glass, but I totally did the nod to Topanga from Boy Meets World and the crew. Chicken home, Granyama. Okay. How can you not think? I've thought that since I was a kid. I was like, it's Topanga.
That's the first time I ever thought of that, actually.
Oh, come on. There's even memes about it now, but that was my idea, Fresh Baked. I thought of that first. I want to sit in this chair, because it just looks...
uncomfortable?
Yes.
Yeah? Not too bad?
It's not bad. Sit in it. Try it. Because they can't see me sitting in it, so you can... I'd prefer the couch, but...
It's really not bad.
It's not.
It looks a lot worse.
It looks terrible, but it's somewhat comfy.
I mean, like, lay back and watch TV, no, but it's not a bad seat.
If you're 8, it's like, it's perfect.
It's perfect.
And check that. Is there anything in the drawer? I feel like there should be...
It's a big drawer, like a store.
Wow.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I guess this has...
That's so cool. Okay, I don't know. I'm just being excited. Just be excited. Overall, I'm pretty impressed.
Yeah.
Extra pillows. This is cool. This was the best part. I thought this was just the dining room table. I had no idea.
Missed it.
Wow. A Murphy bed.
Can I back up?
I don't know. Will something go wrong? Because you know what they say. If it can go wrong with your Murphy bed, it probably will. That's the Murphy bed law.
I don't know if it like locks or something.
Murphy's
like
bed law? I don't know. Bedlam? I don't know. I'm just thinking, you look like you belong there.
I do belong here.
You look like such a teacher, actually. Like there should be 2 8-year-olds right here.
Okay, kids.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Alright, Fresh Baked. Well, I'm going to move on. I guess, I guess this is the room. We're going to hang out here. We're going to, chill for a little bit before we head to Animal Kingdom, I guess.
Have you seen the rest of the resort?
I'm sorry. We are going to do that. We're going to go walk around. So I looked at the Finding Nemo pool.
Yeah.
I looked at Timon and, Simba and all them.
Mm-hmm.
The fat looking dude.
Pumbaa?
Thank you.
Yeah.
On the log.
Simone, what did you say? Simone.
Did I say Simone?
I don't know if you did
Simone! Oh, just beat it. That joke. Anyway, Michael Jackson, Simone.
Oh, sorry.
This is going downhill quickly for us, right? But I want to go see Scar in the Elephant Graveyard.
Yeah.
And then maybe the Car Suite. And then, is there a Little Mermaid? Are there 4?
Yeah, I've stayed at Little Mermaid here.
Okay.
That's why I know a little bit about the resort, but we're near Little Mermaid. Cars is kind of on the other side of the property.
Oh, okay.
But, I mean, we can still run over there and see it, because there's some, like, just like there's those big, like,
Cars?
Just like Simone Mac is really big, they have all the cars.
Shut up, that doesn't even make sense.
Like Lightning McKean.
Timon, okay,
yes.
Yeah. So Lightning's big and Mater and all them.
Yeah.
Dude, really that's cool. Awesome. That's as close to Cars Land as we can get out here.
Exactly.
Okay, we're going to do this. All right, but we are going to sit down and relax maybe for a minute. I'm going to get water.
Yeah.
And then, because it's hot outside. All right, cool. See you soon. Okay.
There's a light.
There we go. Okay.
You're welcome.
All right. Thank you. All right, Fresh Baked. I'm making an executive decision, I think, here. So this is where I checked in, and that's the gift shop that I was in. And then this is the pool where I was in. And then I walked all the way down this trail. And then right here, that's where Simba was crossing with Simone. And then I turned in here. So we have dinner at Tiffins at Animal Kingdom, which is one of the signature dinings, in an hour. So I was going to go check out the Little Mermaid area and then go all the way back down here to the Cars area of the resort and show you guys everything, but I'm not going to do it this week. I think I'm going to do it on Saturday, kind of like a part 2.
Awesome.
Because that was David's idea. He said, just do it next Saturday. I was like, okay, good idea. So we're going to finish off the show this week at Tiffin's. I'll probably film in there because it's that I did do research on like the stupid bed.
And I didn't research Tiffin's, so that's perfect.
Okay, yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff in there. And then and we're going to do some end the night with Rivers of Light, although I don't know if I'm going to film that because I just did that. Oh, no, I didn't film Rivers of Light yet. Okay, cool. Yeah. So we'll end the night with Rivers of Light. I did that on Periscope, so close enough. All right, so that's the plan. And then we're going to come back next week and finish everything else.
Hey.
Okay, I lied again, Fresh Baked. I had to stop by and look at the elephant graveyard, because look at this. I had to wrap up the show. Look. Look. The hyenas up there. Oh my gosh. And if they were down here, they would be low hyenas. Okay. Bonsai. Yeah. Bonsai, Shenzi, and Ed. That's Ed. I forget which ones.
That's Whoopi Goldberg.
Yeah, I know. Well, duh. What gave that away? The Whoopi locks? I mean, come on. But I forget which one. Anyway, yeah. But it is Bonsai and Shenzi. And then Scar. Just chilling on the old Scar Rock. Scar Rock. That's what it's called, right?
Scar Rock.
Scar Rock.
Absolutely.
Scar Rocks, man. Where's his scar? Oh, there it is. Okay. I couldn't actually see his scar. I was where is his scar? But there it is. It's right there. I pushed in. Okay, we're done. All right, the bus.
This way.
That way. All right, to Animal Kingdom. Okay, I keep saying I'm done. Look how dumb I am, Fresh Baked. Look, I just came from that way. I came from that path right there. I did not even see Mufasa on Pride Rock. Just chilling up there. Thank you for pointing that out, Mr. Reynolds.
Yeah, you're welcome.
See that, because that's where Simba is, and then Mufasa, and then I can't even. I'm just, you know what it is? I need food. Can we go eat?
I'm really weak.
Where's the bus?
Okay,
we're gonna catch the bus. Hey, David.
Hey, what?
How excited are you about Pandora?
I'm really excited about Pandora, actually. I am looking forward to all the new technologies they're gonna use.
Yes.
And seeing all this stuff.
You know what? That's and that's exactly what I thought. Like, I mean, I like the movies, but I'm really excited to see the intervention.
Yes.
That's what I want to see.
I was a big fan of the movie when it came out, however many years ago that was. Now. But I was I've been a little bit hesitant, but seeing some of the, you know, the media sneak peeks, I've been really excited about what I've been seeing.
Yeah. Yeah. The whole The View with Whoopi.
Yeah.
Did you see when Whoopi was at the Haunted Mansion?
No.
Oh my gosh. She donned the full costume and yeah. They made it look like she was there greeting actual guests, but I think it was
it was
set up guests, but it was still pretty funny to see her in the outfit. And speaking of, I kinda got a question.
Wait, speaking of Whoopi?
No. Speaking of Disney.
That's two Whoopi references, by the way.
That is two Whoopi. We're gonna go for three. We're gonna figure it out. We're gonna do this. What does Disney mean to you?
What does Disney mean to me?
Mm-hmm. Such a simple question, but so...
But very complicated.
So rich.
Answer.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's a really good question. Disney as in, like, I don't know how to answer that.
Right? Especially when you're caught off guard.
Right. Thanks for the heads up. I think... If I had to sum it up into like one word, it would be imagination. Is that too vague of an answer?
No.
Because I think like...
There is no vague answer here, because it's what it means to you.
Right, because I think they do a really good job of... It's inspiring imagination in people, but I also think they do a really good job of imagining things... Imagineers, right? Imagining things themselves, right?
Right.
But, I don't know.
Yeah? No, that's true. To me, it's about, since you asked.
Yes. Oh, yeah. What about for you, Laramie?
It's about an escape.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I've always liked, you know, appreciated movies, the Disney movies. Here, I'm not ready for security yet. Let's go over here. I've always appreciated the, just movies in general, you know, and film and things like that, but...
Yeah.
The big thing with Disney is just ever since I was a kid, the escaping into those worlds were always just worlds that I could relate to all the characters.
Yeah.
Like,
and I think
so
that's
much.
For me, like that it captured my imagination and took me to those places, kinda like going with what you were saying. Yeah,
exactly.
For sure.
And it was just and they were worlds that I could go to over and over and over and over and over and over and over, and over, and over again.
Right.
Like everyone, you know? Yeah. But those, and that's, this is just scratching the surface. I mean, that's like, just off the top of my head, what Disney means to me. I mean, these guys are sick of it, I'm sure. Because I'm in Disney World. Everyone's probably like, shut up, stop talking about Disneyland. But to me, that's what Disney is. It is Disneyland because I grew up with it. First time I went was when I was 4. I went to Disneyland. And I was there constantly as a kid. I had my first annual pass wasn't until 2011, but I had one. Speaking of annual passes, let's go in the annual pass holder line. But
annual pass holders?
Yes, sir.
That's what it is to me. You know, Disneyland. The wonder of it all. You stopped listening. You're focused on checking in.
I am, I'm sorry. The wonder of it all.
I heard that part.
Yes. Here we go. That's
so
okay.
So many things going on, and I have to bebop, and the thing, and the thumbprint, and the...
It's fine. It's fine. It's fine.
Ooh, look at that. Wow.
Pandora, and the sun. Okay.
Disneyland, and it's...
Yeah, the wonder, and the amazement, and the awe. And for me, like, why... Those, like, so much of the stuff there has always been my favorite is because it's such an escape into, like, each of the rides.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, and especially, I think that's definitely shaped who I am as an actor because I work from the outside in. Mm-hmm. So being in that environment and, you know, in my wardrobe, that's what helps me transform.
Yeah.
You know, and so, and same with Disney, just being there feels like a complete escape from reality, and it's always been attractive to me. It's always amazing. So
I feel like this part, maybe even more so than the other ones in Disney World,
mm-hmm.
I feel that escape here at this part. Like I feel completely, this is going to sound like I work for Disney, but feel like I'm completely transported to a different place.
Well, you should work for Disney. Everyone says that. Have you not seen the comments? See? Oh, don't test. Ugh. It's the paper. I pick up bottles and stuff, but not...
It's just a napkin.
Gross. Okay. Good for you. Good job. Thank you for keeping our parks clean. Where's the uncle eater?
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. It's the one that today...
I never knew there was an anteater. Did you know that there... Hey. Come here. There is a crocodile. Or an alligator. Oh, yes! I didn't know that.
Yes.
And I'm going to show Fresh Bake that after dinner. No idea. Anyway, is it an alligator or a I think it's an American alligator.
Yeah, maybe.
Or a I don't know. We'll find out. It's incredible. It's been here for forever, and I just noticed it. But anyway, we were talking about good stuff. Mm-hmm. Escape.
Yes. Oh, and yeah. I was just saying, like, here, I feel like there's a...
That's right, yeah.
They really, truly do a good job of transporting you to a different area of the world.
Yes. No, that's for sure. Like, Africa, I've never been there, but I feel like I could be.
Absolutely.
For sure. And that's why, I mean, Epcot, I think, is still my favorite.
Yes.
Because I also like the relaxation of the parks.
Yeah.
And I get that with Epcot. Do not get it with Magic Kingdom or Hollywood Studios at all.
Right.
But when I'm at Epcot, and then second, which is a pretty close second here, I definitely feel that relaxation.
Huh? Yeah, absolutely.
So.
Maybe not so much this week, but.
Yeah, maybe not so much. That's a lot of, peeps. But look at that tree.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty nice. And you know what we got to do? We got to go see if that pathway that goes right by the tree,
yeah.
which I've never filmed yet, but I keep looking at and keep forgetting to film.
Yeah, I went last time I was here, so it was back open.
Yeah. We need to go there. But right now, Fresh Baked, we are going to go check in to Tiffins. Actually, I'm going to get a fuel rod from right in there. And then we're going to check in to Tiffins and eat a fantastic dinner.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll show you guys everything, just like I showed with Ohana. And dinner is sponsored by the lovely David Reynolds. Thank you so much in advance, because I know it's going to be amazing.
I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm very excited. David, let's pretend that you're not doing that dance. let's pretend that Pandora is open. And right there, because that's the gate, Fresh Baked, right there, right where those people are. Soon, May 27th. Look at that. Look at the flying mountains up there. We'll push in again. Oh, so exciting. So beautiful. I'm sure you guys have all seen some of the footage on God, it's been everywhere. Like, all the Good Morning America, The View. The View actually filmed here, like, a week ago.
Yeah.
So that was cool. We definitely knew about it. But, yeah. That's where it'll be, you guys. And it's going to be fantastic. I can't wait. Cannot wait. But then, how long?
69.
69 days from right now, huh?
Sure.
Yeah, that's...
I started counting on Pandora.com.
Oh, okay. You're very bright. Let's... There we go.
I am very bright.
Well, I meant this... That's Pat. All right. Thanks, Pat. Well, there you go. You heard it from Pat. 69 days. It's going to be open, and it's going to be amazing. Although, I won't say why, but I might get to see it before 69 days. Woo-hoo! as will Pat, I'm sure. So we're very, very excited. But yeah, it's gonna be cool, you guys. I'm excited. But anyway, check this out. This is Tiffins. We're here.
There's a menu over here.
There is. Yeah, I'm gonna show them the menu here. And by the way, if you guys haven't downloaded My Disney Experience, you should for Disney World, because this is where you can see all the good stuff that's here. So check this out. Appetizers: lobster popcorn Thai curry soup, which is supposed to be amazing. Not super spicy from what I read, but
sounds awesome.
Not overloaded with lobster either, but you get a couple bites in there. Marinated grilled octopus. Doesn't have that octopus consistency from what I was reading online. Black-eyed pea fritters, flash fried icy blue mussels, apple walnut salad. Look at this. All sorts of amazing stuff. There's a bread service. You do get bread with your meal, so I don't know why I would pay $10 to get more bread, but unless it's just completely out of this world. And then we have our main entrees, the rubbed chicken.
Charmoula.
Charmoula. Charmoula.
That's the charmoula rubbed chicken.
Well, yeah, because look at all the moula it is. It's the charmoula. Duo of lamb. Pork tenderloin, grilled swordfish, head-on prawns, roasted vegetable curry. That's the most popular one right there, the Wagyu strip loin and braised short rib. The whole fried sustainable fish is supposed to be good, duck breast, all sorts of good stuff, you guys. And then for dessert, we've got calamansi mousse, which is that the one? Yeah, that's the one everyone keeps saying you gotta get. The lime cheesecake, passion fruit, tapioca cream, sorbet tasting. South American chocolate ganache, which is not getting good reviews, although it sounds amazing and looked amazing too. But kids meals too, you know, typical kids fares, Mickey Chuck meals or entrees there. So yeah, that's Tiffin's. And then inside, I'm gonna film inside once we actually sit down. We're still waiting.
Yeah,
it's gonna be a few minutes before we get to do it, but we've got, look at all these. We got outdoor patio area. As far as where we're at, so right back there is the Tree of Life. And then, if you turn left and go back that way, that's Africa. And then the main entrance is right there, because that's where Pandora is, right by the main entrance. And, Dino Land's way back that way, and Everest is over there. So it's, Tiffins is definitely tucked away back here. But look at these sculptures on the roof. Like, this is kind of like an art gallery restaurant. It's gonna be amazing. You guys are gonna see some pretty cool artwork. And I'm even gonna show you Joe Rohde's personal favorite art piece that's in here. He said it, so it's gonna be cool, you guys. You're gonna have a lot of fun. Okay, so Fresh Baked. We got our table, and we are in, where are we? You tell him, you heard it.
She said we were in the main gallery, and
gentlemen, good evening.
Oh, hi.
Oh, no, you're
David.
Fine.
That's my
you're
name
fine.
Too, David.
That's your name?
Yeah.
We have good names, then.
Yes,
is this your first time at Tiffins?
Yes.
Yes.
Very good, very good. And so go ahead, settle in. I'm going to bring two cold waters for the both of you. When I get back, I'll make some recommendations. We'll get started. And I'm aware that we're also part of the River of Lights package.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So per person, you can each have an appetizer, a main course, and a dessert.
Great.
It's a great way to take advantage of our menu. So I'll be right back, okay?
Awesome. Very good. Thanks. So, I did not know this.
How about?
Okay.
So it's the main gallery.
Uh-huh.
I think that's what she's in. And it's inspired by the Disney Conservation Fund, or like sponsored by? Probably inspired by the Disney Conservation Fund.
Right. And from what I read, the art on the wall, I got pushed in here so you guys can see the detail. But each one of these on the wall, they actually, I think it said that they helped inspire Rivers of Light. Because this was here before Rivers of Light. But Tiffins has been open, I think, for less than a year. It's a pretty new restaurant, you guys. Or if it is around that year mark, it's just barely. So it's pretty amazing, though, in here. Yeah, absolutely beautiful. Joe Rohde's art isn't in here, so I'm going to take a walking tour probably in a little bit here once we order some appetizers and settle in. But butterflies in all of these sculptures here. So this is cool. These came from the old, the Mickey's area? The kids' play
Camp
area?
Mini Mickey.
Yes. They came from there, and they scraped off all the paint. And so now they just have the totems.
So where are we traveling from, gentlemen?
All the way from Celebration, Florida.
Oh, that's where I live.
Is it?
We're neighbors.
But he's from Tennessee.
So. Oh, okay. Very cool.
Yeah.
I've never been to Nashville, but my best friend and his family have an obsession with Tennessee, and they're there all the time. I've never been, but they invite me, and they said it's, like, really, really fun.
Yeah, it's a fun place.
So on the front page, do you already know what you want?
No.
Okay, very good. See, I saw close menu, so I'm like, wow, they're ready.
Oh, yeah, no, not at all. Look at these menus.
Very good, very good. Grilled octopus, very unique to our restaurant. Normally, octopus is very rubbery, like calamari or squid. Ours is very different. We actually prepare it with we sous vide it in coconut water, and then we char grill it. It turns out to be really soft and tender because of that. And then all the way towards the bottom is the soup. It's a nice, creamy, delicious soup. Not spicy at all, but we do make it with curry, so it's going to be a little tangy. We centerpiece it with a little bit of lobster, pop sorghum, which is basically another word for popcorn, as well as basil emulsion, and we do it tableside for you if it's something you're interested in. If you flip the page over, on the top left-hand side is our signature dish. It's for the meat lovers. It's going to be a Wagyu strip one and braised short rib. The rib is braised for 72 hours. The Wagyu is all the way from Colorado. Both meats are really a delicacy. They're very soft and tender. It gets paired with some Peruvian purple potatoes, which are crispy on the outside, soft on the inside, and some rainbow carrots. And then we drizzle a little bit of chimichurri vinaigrette on top of everything. And lastly, on the top right-hand side is the whole fried sustainable fish. Today, it's going to be yellowtail snapper. It is the whole fish with the head and the tail. I know it's scary sounding, but I promise you, if you're a fish fan, it is absolutely the best. We lightly fry the fish for a nice crispy skin. Underneath the fish, we serve it with a delicious Som Tam papaya slaw, and then we accompany that with a very chewy black rice that we call forbidden rice. It's basically like a next step up from brown rice, very chewy. And then after that, we underneath the rice, the papaya slaw, and the fish is a really buttery sauce. It's a black bean sauce that we ferment that goes really well with everything. When I eat it, I like to make a mess out of everything and just it's like a big mess of everything and just eat it.
But what's your favorite here?
Those two are my favorite.
Those two, are they really?
Absolutely. We used to have a grouper that I used to spiel with the Wagyu, but we no longer have it.
Yeah.
So now I spiel the whole fish. All right, enjoy. Nice. Take your time. I'll be back in a minute, okay?
Thanks, David. Certainly. I probably should have warned him and not just been like, hey, hi, how are you?
It's okay.
I just zoomed in on him. Anyway, so yeah, these were from Camp Mini Mickey. So they brought them here. But
which is where Pandora is.
Oh, that's where it is? That was Camp Mini Mickey?
Was out that way.
Oh, out that way.
Well, I don't know where we are, but yes.
Yeah.
Well, and part of the new... where they expanded Africa. It may have been over on that side too.
Oh, okay.
Actually, now that I think about it.
Because I thought it was Dino Land.
No, back where, I think, now that I'm thinking about it, it may be back where they added the Festival of Lion King new theater back there. Because the Festival of Lion King, now I'm all confused. Festival of the Lion King, the show used to be at Camp Mini Mickey.
People have literally paused the video right now, and the muffins are putting like 15 comments below telling us exactly where it was. Yes.
Thank you already. You have Google and I don't. But anyway, so I really do think that it's part where the
yeah, no Google. Is. I might have just. No, you don't have to.
But anyway,
it was here. Yeah, so that's cool.
Yeah.
But there's different rooms. Like, look at this. Here's some more art, fresh baked. Look at that in this room. I mean, talk about very Animal Kingdom inspired in here. And you know what I'm struck by? It's like, it's super quiet. Like,
it is very, it has a very distinct mood.
Yes.
Definitely does.
It's the perfect mood for whipping out a camera and, and filming.
It's fine.
But no, it's not bad. It's, yeah, I'm excited to take the tour. We actually came in here on one of my learning days, so it was cool. So I got to learn and take a look at Tiffin's here. But anyway, all right, Fresh Baked. We're going to take a look at the menu, decide what we want, order, and then I'll give you guys a tour here. Okay, so I did not mean to copy you.
But you did.
I did on everything. So we started off with, what's it called, Jen's Tattoo?
Yes.
So Jen's Tattoo, which is a watermelon vodka hibiscus flower drink, and apparently the hibiscus is edible, which I'm totally intending on trying. Mm-hmm. And then for an appetizer, we got the popcorn lobster curry soup. And what happens is see, so all these little bits you see, that's actual popcorn. But I thought it was, go ahead. I thought it was gonna be like popcorn shrimp. It's gonna be popcorn lobster. But no, it's actual bits of popcorn, which is very interesting. Let's see what David thinks of it.
Oh, it's really good.
Is it good?
It is good. It's not at all what I expected.
Oh, well, good. All right. So I'm excited. And then we both got, for dinner, we both got the Wagyu.
Copied again.
Except I know how to eat it. Medium rare is the only way you eat steak. Come on, period. Unless you're eating a ribeye, in which case you want it medium. So the marbling soaks in. Yeah, I used to be a butcher, okay? I'm a snob. How is it? Second bite, better?
Yeah, there is a little bit of spice, though, in the back of my throat.
Yeah, but not, like, overwhelming, right?
No, oh, heavens, no. Okay. That curry does, like, you can feel it.
Nice. All right.
It's really good.
Well, we're going to enjoy this fresh baked, and then, yeah, I'll see you again at the main course. So, thoughts on the soup?
So delicious.
Yeah, I kind of have to agree with you. You guys.
This bread's really good too, though.
Oh, the bread. Yeah, so we got bread. It comes with the meal. And it came with like a pomegranate molasses sauce, something. Yeah, which is pretty bitter. But the bread is sweet. The bread is almost like a raisin bread, it tastes like, but there's no raisins. Mm-hmm. But it's, yeah. And then the bitterness of the pomegranate sauce is just fantastic on the bread. And then, by the way, this little hibiscus flower literally tastes like fruit by the foot. It's amazing.
It's really good.
It's really good. Thank you. So, yeah, so far, very impressed. And the drink is amazing as well. Watermelon. Jen's Tattoo is what the drink is. So, still need to figure out who Jen is.
Jen Tracker?
It could be Jen Tracker. She actually probably does have tattoos, I think. Does she have a tattoo? I don't know. Jen, do you have a tattoo? Tell me in the comments if you watch. But anyway, I'm excited for the main course. I'm very excited.
Me too.
Look, the face of excitement.
I mean,
look at this food, fresh baked. So these three right here is the strip loin, and then the short rib is in the back, these two pieces, with some, it looks like we got some potatoes.
Probably don't eat the steak knife, but here it is.
Okay, thank you. And I don't see, I was looking for green beans.
No, there are no, let me get you a side of green beans. Sorry.
Okay, no worries, thank you. But I don't know, what are the strip, it looks like bacon.
I think that's the rainbow carrots.
Oh, it is rainbow carrots. Oh, interesting. Gross. I just don't like carrots. I'll probably try them because they're new and interesting. But is that? I wonder if that's like a mint paste. Because I don't know. Anyway, looks fantastic. That's how much food there is if you can measure it to my hand.
It's definitely a mint paste.
A mint paste?
Yeah.
See, I wonder if it's so like...
Don't eat it by itself.
You know what we are? We're classy.
Very. Wait, no, not yet. Now I'm classy.
There you go. Pinkies up. But the, I wonder, I'll bet it's the same as when I got the lamb shank at Food and Wine.
So finish them off for you, they'll be out very soon for you.
Okay, thank you. The lamb shank at Food and Wine had like that mint paste with potato crumbles. So I'm very excited to see if this is the same stuff. Anyway, I gotta stop filming because he's eating. My food's getting cold, so we're gonna enjoy this.
Like I don't know what to do.
We have a conundrum, fresh baked. See,
I don't know what to do.
Here's the problem. David is down to one bite of carrot.
Oh, that's it.
And one bite of Wagyu steak. Tell us in the comments what he should eat, and we'll wait till next week before he eats it. We'll get a doggy bag. We won't. You have a fridge in the room. It's fine. This will air on, like, Wednesday, so... Oh, he's going the meat? Wow. He really likes that carrot.
I do really like the carrot.
I really liked everything, except the nasty carrots that look like bacon. I wasn't a fan, but... Oh, my gosh. This... The green, so that paste, it wasn't a mint paste, it was a chimichurri.
Chimichurri.
Chimichurri, thank you. Yeah, chimichanga.
That's from Mary Poppins. Chim-chim-churri.
Chim-chim-churri, chimichanga, chupacabra. That's what it was. Chupacabra sauce.
Yes, the chupacabra sauce.
And it was delicious. Yeah, I smothered my steak in it. And I'm actually very full in that drink. Oh my gosh, the watermelon. Oh, it's so good, you guys.
Very sweet though, so if you're not into a sweet drink,
yeah,
don't do this.
Not for you.
It's really good.
Very, very good. But yes, and now we're on to dessert, which I don't know what I'm gonna do. We gotta look at the dessert menu again.
Yeah,
but
I'm sure he'll bring this through.
Yeah, but the lime cheesecake was supposed to be pretty decent, but that other, they're famous for like this mousse. It's like a, whatever that first one was, it was like a fruit mousse or passion something, I don't know.
I'm probably going to do the sorbet. Like, I think it was like a trio of sorbets or something like that.
Yeah, it's like three bites. I don't know. I don't...
A really good sorbet, I would imagine.
Well, we'll let you know. We'll keep you posted. Hey, David.
Hey, what?
Lift up your drink real quick. Just do it, trust me. So, fresh baked. Tiffins backwards is sniff it. I don't know why that's funny. You laughed a second ago.
It's funny.
I thought it was funny. Anyway, so I didn't actually say. So Tiffins is a word for a, like, a container.
Oh.
That you can take, like, when you go on the Wild Africa trek, which is a tour here, you take Tiffins. They're like metal containers that hold food for travel, so.
Interesting.
The more you know.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can see the, right above. Yep. The shooting star. Okay, so dessert menu time. We saw this on the outside already, fresh baked, but I think I'm going to go with the calamansi mousse, because that is supposed to be good. And you're getting the sorbet?
Or the ganache.
Okay, so.
Or the cheesecake,
or the carrot.
Yeah, I could go for another thing of carrots, too.
But look at this, you guys. So they got all sorts of different dessert wines. Cognac, if you want 2 ounces of cognac there, it's only $2.55, so that's good. And then we've got all sorts of coffee to choose from. Hot coffee cocktails, Irish coffee and whatnot. And then a whole page dedicated just to tea, so you can order tea. And then on the back, we have single malt scotches, blend scotch, or blended scotch, whiskeys, cordials.
I think the muffin had it right when they called you. Have I said on film? I haven't.
You haven't.
Okay. So a muffin told me via Instagram message that...
When did we make up our minds?
Yes.
Hey, gentlemen.
Boy, were you saved by David.
Right. I'm going to go with the sorbet.
Very good for you, sir.
I will do the calamansi mousse, please.
Sorbet. Very good. Please.
Thank you, sir.
You were saved.
Via Instagram message.
It's fine, actually. I think it's pretty funny.
That David Reynolds here reminds her, I think it was a her. Ooh, I don't even know now. Pretty sure.
I don't know who it was.
But she said... If Sarah and Ian were to procreate and they had a giant man baby, that would be David. And you know what? I'm sorry. I think she nailed it.
I mean, I'm flattered because I think the two of them are great. Giant man baby? Come on.
He's actually not that tall, so.
No, I'm short. But yeah.
Oh, gosh. Hilarious. Anyway. You know what? Dessert's coming.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what?
You're excited.
Very excited. David, what you got there?
Sorbet. It's like lychee and the other thing that he said.
Dragon.
Yeah. No, passion fruit.
Passion fruit. Yeah, yeah. Passion dragon fruit? Passion fruit with dragon
this crouton is something else too, or this like little.
Yeah, and there's like a sauce. Apparently, from what the reviews said, stop touching stuff.
I'm sorry.
I'm trying to film it. That yellow sauce is supposed to be amazing, so.
Oh, good.
Enjoy that. And then I got the calamansi mousse. Yeah, that is indeed gorgeous. Look at this, you guys. Just, I mean, talk about presentation here. Well done, chef. Yeah, that looks fantastic. So.
Oh my goodness.
I'm very excited.
Oh my goodness.
What are you doing?
I'm eating.
Oh, okay.
That yellow is really good.
Is it really good?
It is.
What is it? What's it taste like?
No idea, but it's really tart. It's like a tart, like citrus almost.
Oh, nice.
It's delicious.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna, well, okay, here. Let's just, you know what?
Go for it.
They have not yet seen me. So I'm going to take a bite of this. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Good?
Yeah, it's good. That's like, oh my gosh, it's like, it's spongy. Citrusy, like light citrus.
Mm-hmm.
That's very good. Let's see what the sauce is.
It's like a caramel?
No. That's like a, kind of like a cinnamon honey.
Oh.
But it's like a, it's a real light honey. It's not like sticky. It's more of a sauce. And then I don't know what the outer. Oh my gosh. Pomegranate. That outside, wow. This is fantastic. And then this, is that chocolate or is that just plastic?
Chocolate. They're not gonna serve you plastic, bro.
Well, well.
Hey, these croutons taste like Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
See, you don't see the glare. I'm giving him fresh baked.
Gentlemen, I have your River of Lights tickets here.
Oh, thank you.
So show up at the Finding Nemo Theater towards the Dino Land site at 8:15. They'll take care of you with those seats. They're guaranteed good seats at priority. So after Fast Pass, it's you and then the standby guest.
Awesome.
Okay. Very good. Cool. Thanks, David.
Oh, you're welcome.
That's so good. Not you. The guy that actually helped. Oh, wait, you bought dinner. Thanks, David.
You're welcome.
Yeah, this was amazing, man. Thank you. Oh, so good. And the flour. I can't wait to get. I don't know what that flour is made out of, but I'm sure it might be chocolate. I don't know.
The flour?
Yeah. The flour. Oh, so maybe they will serve plastic if they'll serve you a flower.
But the flour is edible.
No, it is not. That's an actual flower, dude. It, look, that's a... Really?
What?
You're disgusting.
Why?
You just ate a flower.
It's a pansy.
It's a pansy?
Isn't that what that's called?
I don't know.
It's called a pansy.
So I had a friend that used to eat flowers like rose petals and stuff, like back in the 80s. He's like, oh, they're good. They're full of vitamins and stuff like that. And
now he's dead?
Yes. Yes.
Sorry about it.
So what did it taste like? It wasn't good. It tasted like a flower.
No, it just tasted like, I don't know.
Okay.
Like a flower.
So you're eating your dessert and I'm not eating mine.
Yeah.
So fresh baked, I'm going to eat my dessert. And we're going to enjoy this. So we are done with our dinner, fresh baked, and it was amazing, but I wanted to show you guys this real quick. So this is another room, the Safari Gallery room here, and I don't want to interrupt everyone's dinner in here, but look, this right here is Joe Rohde's favorite piece of artwork that is done in here. It's something electrical, because those are all electrical wires. See that? And they like, I think, I don't know if they light up the artwork or what, but it's just, yeah. Joe Rohde, of course, being the head Imagineer and pretty much lead designer, the vice president of creations of Animal Kingdom, so. But all sorts of amazing artwork in this dining room, which is really cool. And then you come over to this tree and look at this. Got a baobab tree chilling out on the wall, just a piece of art. So really, really, really cool. But I don't want to hang out in here
too long. I don't want to look like a tourist like that guy. He's going to kill me. He's going to be like, with his Tennessee accent, when he watches this, he'll be like, so what? I look like a tourist. That wasn't a Tennessee accent. I don't know. Anyway, I'm just making fun of him because it's fun. I love David. And then, yeah, different... I'm not sure what's going on here. Just different little sketch pads and artwork. Because Tiffins is kind of like... Just like the whole thing is like an art gallery. So we sat literally right there at that table. That's where we sat. And then right there is the art gallery room I was just in. And then look at this. This whole board is just different pictures of probably the Imagineers' trips to Africa. Like you can see right there, like this archway looks just like some of the Expedition Everest queue. You know, and like there's something else David pointed out to me. What else did you say? Besides this, what were you telling? Oh, this right here. So this looks like so there's a hidden Mickey, like there's a section in Africa where Grace and I, when the very first day we filmed, we sat in there and we ate, but right, if you were here in this picture and you kept walking, right about here, that's where there's that hidden Mickey on the wall. It says, what's it say, Fitzwa?
Fishwa Fellow.
Fishwa Fellow, yeah, which means hidden fellow, and it's a picture of Mickey, which is really cool. So that, this archway looks just like that, which maybe we can go over there and I can just point that out.
There's
That'd be
Jamari.
Funny. Oh, is it?
Yeah, standing right there.
Oh, this yeah. Yeah, that's him right there, too, isn't it? Yeah.
He's over in this other one.
So there's
right.
Joe Rohde right there, yeah, the head Imagineer. So, pretty, it's funny. The Imagineer ear, Joe Rohde's ear.
Speaking of which,
which is cool. Oh, yes. There you go. There is the famous Joe Rohde ear right there, fresh baked. Which is cool. He's an amazing guy. All the Imagineers from Marty Sklar. I mean, you name, oh my gosh. Awesome. Awesome guys. But we're going to keep walking. We're going to go on over here. I think David and I are, that drink was so good that we had. So here's the main check-in area with the whole map of the world here. But the Nomad Lounge over here with more pictures, more photographs, probably of the Imagineers. Yeah, there's Joe Rohde again. Right there with some sort of animal. Kitty or dog? I don't know. Yeah. Oh, look, there's is that Kilimanjaro? It's gotta be, right? Yeah. Mount Kilimanjaro there. But anyway, inside the Nomad Lounge, which is the bar area and waiting area, look at this. Absolutely incredible, you guys. Very, very comfortable. You can grab a drink in here, maybe some appetizers. I don't know if you can do appetizers or not, but they got these big banners hanging. It's just Tiffin's, man. The restaurants, the signature dining experiences are just that, fresh baked. They are experiences, and they're absolutely amazing. So, I'm in love with this place. I love it. The food was fantastic. Company was even better, but the food was fantastic. And, there you go. There's some grilled octopus in that bowl, which was an appetizer we skipped out on. But, yeah, this looks good. So I think we're gonna enjoy another drink here, and then we're gonna head to our Rivers of Light because we did a dinner package, which combines dinner here at Tiffin's with the Rivers of Light show. And we have Rivers of Light on Fresh Baked Presents, so you can watch the whole show there. But I'm still gonna get it because we haven't included it in the actual trip report. So I'm gonna show you guys the show in the trip report this week, edited of course, as per David's discretion. But we're gonna do as much as we can. Oh, look at this! What? Oh my gosh, are you serious? I've never walked out here.
Oh, that's what I was talking about before. Houston, this wall that needs to be here so you can see all the way in.
So there's, okay. So there's the bridge. Here, let's film right here. Poke my head out. So that right there, guys, that's the bridge. That goes into Pandora. And right there, they put that wall up. But look, you can see some lanterns right there. Oh, this is cool. Look how beautiful this is, you guys. Just awesome. Well, maybe we can get a table out here. We're going to try. But can we just sit? Let's find out. All right, you guys. So that's where we just were, inside the Nomad Lounge in there. But this right here, you can come on up. It's all right. This right here is the, so that's the entrance to Pandora right back there. So we grabbed a nice little seat right here, and we're gonna enjoy another cocktail before the show. And Grace is gonna join us too, not here, but like later on, yeah, after the show. Probably gonna, I think we're all three gonna go ride some Dinosaur, which is cool. But dude, this is pretty amazing.
Yeah, because it's a similar menu to what we had at Tiffins, drink menu wise. And we were able to just walk up and have a seat at one of the tables.
Yeah, we had no reservation, no nothing. We just do it, which come the summertime, is it gonna be that easy when there's a lot of people? Probably not, yeah, but yeah, I think I'm going to stick with that same drink, because that was amazing. But David's going to get something else here, but we're going to chill, let our food coma relax a little bit, because I'm actually quite full. It all hit me. It hit me, David. It hit me. 1-2 punch. I don't know how it happened, Fresh Baked, but it got into nighttime, and we are in a mass of people trying to rush to our reservation for Rivers of Light, because dinner was amazing, drinks at Nomad Lounge were amazing, which I didn't even film. Oh my gosh, we were periscoping. I forgot to film it. Okay, good job,
follow
Laramie.
Follow him on Periscope.
Yeah, follow me on Periscope. Please, we will have a lot of fun, because I only had 145 viewers, I think, that last scope there, when I know there's 2,000 of you, some 3,000 that watch each video. So yeah, follow me on Periscope, just at Laramie Williams or Fresh Baked WDW. Maybe that's the problem. I don't even know my name on Periscope. I'm giving them inaccurate information. But anyway, we have fun, so follow me there. But now, yeah, we're gonna head on over to our special reserved viewing of Rivers of Light. And it will be a good time. Look, 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 Fresh Baked, fireflies in the trees. It's so awesome, you guys. I'm looking forward to giving the show a second chance. Like, I say a second chance, it makes it sound like I hated it the first time I saw it. Not true. I just think there are some things they could have done better, like the projections. I think they could have cleaned them up a little bit. But I think we're about to start the pre-show here very, very shortly.
There's a pre-show?
There is a pre-show.
Ooh, exciting.
Are you saying you're very excited?
Yeah, I am actually very, very excited.
Most welcome guests. Namaste.
Namaste.
And welcome to Rivers of Light, a celebration of nature's wonder told through music, water, and light. Throughout this evening's celebration,
see.
It's all right, it's all cold. Every creature is getting small. It's not alone, it's not alone.
David.
It was so good.
He cried twice, fresh baked. He cried twice.
And I ain't afraid to say it either.
No, you shouldn't be. That was awesome.
It was just beautiful.
Well, I kept looking over at you while I was filming. And
I probably look like this.
That is exactly how you looked. That is it, fresh baked. And, but more wonder. Look, he was more like, he was just like. Just. Like, you didn't know where to look.
Everything
you were awesome.
Was so great. It was so good.
So it was cool. But now we're going to meet up with the Grace, and we're going to head over to Dinosaur, and we're sure as heck not going to do Primeval Hurl.
Aww, I love the Primeval Hurl.
If there's time.
Okay.
All right. Okay, fresh baked. We're gonna sneak up on Grace. She's right there. David is being quite sneaky. We both are. We're gonna. Can we go around?
I don't know.
I think yes. Come this way. Yes. Okay, fresh baked. So Grace is meeting us because we're going to ride Dinosaur, but we're going to sneak up behind her and scare the bejeebies out of her. Hopefully.
Yeah, either that or she's going to like,
Or she's going to punch one of us right in the mouth. Because it's Grace. I mean, come on. Oh, this will be great though. If we can pull this off. Okay. Okay. Where is she? Pushing in. Oh, I would step on a crunchy leaf. Okay. Hold on. I don't see her, you guys. I don't see her. Did we go too far? Is she right there? Oh, she's right there. She's right here. She's right on the other side of the tree. Right there. All right, we're gonna do this. Wait till she looks. Wait, David. Okay, she just looked over. Hold on, she's still looking this way.
You are
Cameron. Hey, Grace!
Okay. That spooked me. Okay.
We were stalking you from way back there. We went all the way around.
Wow, really? Okay.
And it was so worth it.
And it's going to be in the trip report. So that's... Yay. We just watched you pee your pants.
No, not quite. I jumped out of my skin.
Oh, that was fun. Good job, David. All right, Fresh Baked. So we're going to watch... Dinosaur. We're gonna watch Dinosaur?
We watched Rivers.
We watched Rivers. Okay. We're gonna ride Dinosaur, but I think it's a little too dark to show you guys, so we're gonna have to do this one alone here, but I'll at least get to show you the queue a little bit. You saw who?
Justin.
You saw Justin's car?
Yeah.
Did you talk to him? Did you say, hey, Laramie's been trying to meet you?
No. He doesn't check DMs.
Okay. See, this is why.
Look how beautiful we are.
Oh, that is cute. How long are they here?
Does he know who you are?
No, probably not. I met him in 2015.
You could have said, "Hey, I'm Grace. I work with Fresh Bake."
Ugh. How long are they here? Did you ask?
No, I think Grace might be fired.
I'm Grace.
Really?
They were what?
Dinosaur.
Did they exit that
guy? Yeah, and I was sitting on the ground and I was like, oh, hello, and they're like, hi, and they walked.
Grace.
Come on.
Okay, wonderful. So, Justin, if you're watching this, you just met Grace and she didn't even tell you that. Okay. That's cool. It's fine. Good job.
Well, Rivers of Light was...
Yeah, Rivers of Light was amazing. How do you like them apples?
That's okay.
Have you seen it yet?
I'll see it on the trip report.
Okay. Yeah.
It's true.
It's on Fresh Baked Presents.
Yeah, but there's only 648 people that have watched it on Fresh Baked Presents as of Saturday night.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
And y'all need to watch it because it's amazing.
Well, no, don't tell them to watch it there. They're just gonna, they can watch it on this trip report.
Well, yeah.
As long as David doesn't edit it out.
He might. It's okay.
Yeah, no, it's fine. It's fine.
Or come to Walt Disney World and see it live in person, for real.
Yeah, exactly. Totally. We're going this way. Orientation room A.
If you're able to come see it live in person, do it.
This is the orientation room, eh? And it's dark.
A. Felicia Rashad, right?
Yeah. 90s Felicia Rashad.
Yeah.
It's
okay.
Yeah. Okay, this is scary. Oh my gosh, Fresh Baked. Okay, I think Dinosaur is a very underrated ride.
Yeah, it's really good.
Because that was a lot of fun.
Well, yeah, but I was there, so.
Well, yeah, you were there. And let's not forget Grace, jerk. Hello.
But Grace, you didn't even let me finish. But Grace was there too, yeah. Which made it all the better.
Just keep digging. Hey, let's go look at the alligator. Let's see if the alligator's here on the way out. Because I promised them I would at the very beginning.
If we can see him.
Yeah, well, he's enormous, so we probably can. Or a is it an alligator or a crocodile? I don't know. Let's go find out. We'll go find out. But anyway, back to Dinosaur. It's amazing. I love that ride. We had a lot of fun, guys. And if you follow me on Instagram at FreshBakedWDW, you can see the picture, because I'm going to post it. It was a good picture. It was a very, very good picture. So we're going to go this way. Let's go find ourselves an alligator. Well, there's our answer, Fresh Baked. It's an American crocodile. And do you see him?
Yeah, he's hiding in the shadows under the rock over there. That the camera.
Oh, yeah. There he is. He's right there.
Yeah, see back there where the camera can't see?
Oh, no. The camera sees him just fine.
Oh,
yeah,
good.
He's right there. Yep.
Yeah.
You must be blind if you can't see him. I mean, it's obvious he's just sitting right there.
Right.
Oh, look, he's yawning now. Oh, that's fascinating.
Wow.
Weird. He's playing with that squeaky toy. You see that?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Squeak, squeak.
Oh, my gosh. He just did a backflip. Can't see him, Fresh Baked. Don't worry. You're not missing anything. But he is there. And it's right. So Dinosaur is right back there. The Dino Bite Snacks is right there, so he's just to the left of that. So, yeah, he's there. Go check him out. It's pretty cool. But Animal Kingdom is now closed, Fresh Baked, so I think we're going to, head back to the resort?
Yes, sir.
Maybe hang out there for a couple hours or something?
Yeah.
But, yeah, that's going to do it for us tonight, I think, you guys. It has been a wild ride. Thank you guys so much for coming here. Coming along. What?
Wild ride.
It's been a wild ride. We're at Animal Kingdom.
I like it.
Okay. Could have been a lot wilder. We wish Grace was here. But Grace, do you want to join us next week?
Sure. Yeah.
All right. You heard it here, Fresh Baked. She will join us Friday and or Saturday of next week. And yeah, it's going to be a fun show because David will be here. Grace will be here. They will make fun of me together. It will be a good time. My giant man baby and Grace. It sounds like a good show.
Yeah. Thursdays on NBC. Yeah. Giant man baby and Grace.
Say goodnight, Gracie. Goodnight, Gracie. You don't even know what that's from, do you?
What?
Am I too young?
I'm too young, technically. That was way before my time even, but... That was like in the 50s, I think. It was George Burns and Grace, what was her name? Burns and Gracie.
Gracie DeCoveney. It was David's grandma.
Are you making up facts again?
No.
He is.
Absolutely.
Anyway. Join us back again next week, Fresh Baked. We're gonna be somewhere. I don't know what parks we'll be at, but we'll be having fun. But until then, please, please, please subscribe to me, follow us, Fresh Baked and Stuff now on YouTube, and then also Fresh Baked WDW on Instagram, and Fresh Baked N, just the letter N, Fresh Baked N Stuff on Instagram and on Twitter as well, but that's Fresh with no E, so Fresh Baked N Stuff, and then also I'm on Twitter at Laramie Williams. Please follow me, because I have a lot of fun. You can see all sorts of different photos and learn a little bit more about me on Twitter, so give me a follow there, won't ya? Won't you, Grace? David? Follow me?
I was like,
follow me, please?
I think I have.
Yeah, you already do. You guys are awesome.
I know.
And follow David at Disney, too, on Instagram. How do you spell that?
It's David_@_Disney.
There you go. Yeah. You heard it from the man, the myth, the legend. And follow Grace at?
Grace_Elise1616.
How do you spell Elise? E-L-I-S-E, right?
With an I, yeah.
Grace underscore Elise. Hey, look. Projection show. Let's go watch the projection show. Look, Disney wins, you guys. At their finest. Here we go. We're going to watch a cool projection show on the Tree of Life. Well, that was just delightful.
Perfect way to end, right?
It ended abruptly, I thought, but...
Oh, yeah?
that was a good show. It was still fun. All right. Well, I mean, at this time, Fresh Baked, that is for sure going to do it for us here from Disney's Animal Kingdom. We had a lot of fun. Thanks for coming along, and stay tuned also for part two of next week when we finish up showing the Art of Animation Resort, because I am definitely going to be doing that, so we can see the Cars area.